great soul, dedicated friend.
The grace of God and the aid of your
those
son,
of us
I'm alive.
Please accept my most sincere condolences.
He will live in our memory.
To you, my deepest sympathy.
The Bible is by far the most popular book in the world. Since 1815, it has over 2.5 billion copies sold, and has been published in more than 2,000 languages and dialects. The Bible brought us the Ten Commandments, which some are even active as laws in our legal system. Among the stories the Bible tells us is how God created the world and how Jesus gave his life to save humanity from its sin. According to the Bible, death is not the end of all existence, but only the end to human existence. The soul would rise from the body and either spend eternity in hell to pay for its sin or go to heaven to enjoy the presence of divine angels and all those who live their lives by the Holy Word. Many people disagree with the biblical explanation of what happens after death. Many people believe that the soul doesn't just join angels in heaven or demons in hell, but starts another life embodied in a new body, a body of another human, an animal, or even another life form. That way, the soul will keep on growing, gathering experience and wisdom, rather than facing the final judgment of God. Many prominent historical characters adhered to the ideas of past lives. Henry Ford adopted the theory of reincarnation when he was 26. Also, Walt Whitman claimed to have died 10,000 times. According to a recent survey, a 4% increase has been noted among those who believe in reincarnation when described as the rebirth of the soul in a new body after death. 11 years ago, in 1990, 21% of survey participants agree in reincarnation. Today that number is up to 25%. A quarter of the nation.
I have Mr. Steve Van Zandt here with me, and he is going to tell me a little bit about his experiences of previous lives. So, Steve, do you believe in previous lives?
Yeah, I guess I would say I do.
So why is it that you support this idea of previous lives? Do you remember any of your previous lives, or do you have any other reason?
I wouldn't say that it's really so much of a belief. It just kind of makes sense to me.
So what can you tell me about your personal experience of previous lives? Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, my first life was that she could point out was an Egyptian slave, which more or less tied me to other people. There was another one where I was very recently, well, geologically speaking, I was a German, and the only thing she could tell me about that was that I died very old. I fell down some stairs. It was a very meaningless death. Out of those lives, I know that one of them in particular was very, very important, and the others were kind of fell in there because they formed the ties with the other individuals that I know now, et cetera, et cetera. I was given the reading by a woman. When I went to her, she gave me a story about me being the ward of the state in France, where my father was an executioner, and my father died, and she could only tell me how, was by an arrow in the neck. My place was basically to fulfill the place of my father, so I became an executioner. The reason I was doing that was I was offered the reward of land. That was my ultimate goal, and to reach that goal, I would do anything, which included killing other people, indiscriminately, without mercy. And everything went great. I killed for many years. I became very successful. Ultimately got to a level where I wasn't fighting criminals. I was fighting others of my own rank. And that's where I fell, and when I did fall, I fell hard. and I didn't make it to my ultimate goal, which was the whole point behind the lesson of that life and the lesson of this life is charity, mercy, and tolerance. Good things happen to good people, and bad things happen to bad people. And, you know, there are exceptions to that, but for the general, you know, the general rule is that's what happens.
Thank you.